Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity. Here I'm going to render exposition of Gnostic Gospel of Truth, translated by Robert M. Grant, and it is beautiful. Part 25. The end, you see, is the recognition of Him, God, who is hidden, that is, the Father, from whom the beginning came forth, and to whom will return all who have come from Him. That is what we say, you know, everyone has to give his own account to God. That is, on our physical death, our man, soul, remember soul is man, Matthew 19, marriage parable of marriage and divorce. For this reason, man leaves his mother and father, God. Man is soul and joins with his wife. Wife is flesh. So when they are joined together, they are no more two but one. So our soul is man, returns to our father to give his own account to God. For they, Christ Jesus and the apostles, were made manifest for the glory and the joy of His name, our Father's name. And the name of the Father is represented by the Son. So Son is the chief ambassador of our Father. As in our families, the son carries the seed of the family or represents his tribal father, so we in flesh may be male or female, brown, black or whatever color, represent our Father God and glorify Him through holy deeds of philanthropy. So God stands for mercy. And philanthropy is the way to mercy. It is He, our Father God, who in the beginning gave a name, that is Christ, to Him, Jesus, who came forth from Him. He is the same one, and He begot Him, Christ Jesus, for a son. He, our Father God, gave him is Christ Jesus, His name. His name is His word, which belong to Him, that belong to our Father, He the Father, who possesses everything which exists around Him. So He is all in all. His presence is in everyone. He, God, possesses the name His word. He has the Son who represents Him on this planet. Saints are also His sons, but not the anointed ones, as Christ Jesus is. It is possible for them that this is us to see Him, Jesus. So God the Himself is invisible, so through Jesus we could see Him, see Jesus as the representative of God. You remember when Jesus was doing merciful deeds of philanthropy, He was representing our Father, but when He was preaching gospel, He was representing our mother, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is the tongue in the mouth of Christ Jesus, our Father. The name, His word, however, is invisible. That is, Christ Jesus said, those who have ears to hear, let them hear. You hear His word. His word is in the wind. For it alone is the mystery of the invisible. That means it's the mystery of our Father about to come to ears completely filled with it through the Father's agency. Agency means Christ, or sons of God, or grace. By grace you get it. Remember at Pentecost, when every apostle spoke, then every person over there heard the message in his own language, which no sense can explain. So such is the mysteries of our Father. That is why His word is hidden in the parables. Moreover, as for the Father, His name is not pronounced, but it is revealed through sons, the Christ. So His name is, He is pronounced only through His sons. Remember that when the rabbis, they used to be ideal, as mentioned in Matthew 13:52, then they had the knowledge of the oral and the written Torah, and then they were perfect, and then they had the knowledge of our Father, but not as perfect as Christ Jesus had. At Pentecost, Christ Jesus, the foreman, gave the same wage, Holy Spirit, to each of the 12 workers, making them equal to Himself, the Christ. So they became the twin brethren of Christ Jesus at Pentecost. But they are not the anointed ones. Thus, then the name of our Father is great, or is glorified. Who then has been able to pronounce a name for Him? So those people, saints, apostles, they were able to pronounce the name of our Father, which is His word. This great name, except Him alone to whom the name belongs, that is, His word means it belongs to our Father only. And the sons of the name called saints, and His sons also know the name called saints, in whom the name of the Father is at rest. So the saints, the name of our Father is on their fingertips, at rest, and who themselves in turn are at rest in His name. So they are at rest, mean they have a full knowledge of His name, so they feel comfortable preaching gospel. Since the Father has no beginning, the Father has no beginning mean the Father was eternal. In our Father in flesh, Adam, we are born and die, whilst in our Father in spirit, God, we are made eternal as our Father is eternal. It is He, God, alone who engendered it for Himself. That is why it is called His word, as a name in the beginning, before He had created the aeons, that the name of the Father should be over their heads as a Lord. Because there is no one above Him, that is the real name, which is secured by His authority, remember that God being Himself, you know, there is nobody above Him.